हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, टुडेज टॉपिक इज प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ रिग्रेशन कोफिशिएंट। दैट मींस व्हाट आर द प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ रिग्रेशन कोफिशिएंट। एज यू ऑल नो देयर आर टू रिग्रेशन कोफिशिएंट। व्हेन वी आर स्टडिंग सिंपल रिग्रेशन देन वी गेट टू रिग्रेशन कोफिशिएंट। वन इज बी वाई एक्स एंड अदर वन इज बी एक्स वाई। ओके, वी गेट टू रिग्रेशन कोफिशिएंट। दिस वन इज रिग्रेशन कोफिशियंट ऑफ वाई ऑन एक्स एंड अदर वन इज रिग्रेशन कोफिशियंट ऑफ एक्स ऑन वाई। एंड द फॉर्मूला इज रो, विच इज कोरिलेशन कोफिशियंट इन टू सिग्मा वाई बाय सिग्मा एक्स। एंड हियर इट इज रो, दैट इज कोरिलेशन कोफिशियंट बिटवीन द टू वेरिएबल एक्स एंड वाई। एंड दिस इज द स्टैंडर्ड डेविएशन ऑफ एक्स सीरीज एंड स्टैंडर्ड डेविएशन ऑफ वाई सीरीज। So as we know, these two are regression coefficient and the formula is given in this way. Okay, now let's start with the first property, number one. The property is the GM, that means geometric mean of regression coefficient. I'm writing it in short, regression coefficient. Coefficient, the geometric mean of regression coefficient is correlation coefficient. Okay, coefficient, that is R. Okay, so the geometric mean of this two regression coefficient is this. So as we know, when there are two values, let's suppose x1 and x2, how to find geometric mean? Geometric mean is equal to root over x1 into x2. Okay, so we need to multiply it. So first we need to multiply it. So it is b y x into b x y. So it will be R sigma y by sigma x into R sigma x by sigma y. This will cancel, this will cancel. What left? R square. So it implies that R square is equal to b y x into b x y. That means it implies that R or rho is equal to square root of, plus minus sign here, square root of this bx into bxy. So these two are regression coefficients, so it is in the geometric mean formula that rho, correlation coefficient rho, is equal to root over bx into bxy. So hence the proof that the GM of the regression coefficient is correlation coefficient. Okay. Now let's come to the second one. Second property. Okay, yeah, always remember this sign of the R depend on the sign of this two regression coefficient. If both are positive, R is also positive, and if both are negative, R is also negative. Okay, so this both are negative, it doesn't mean R is negative, but it depend on the sign. As I have written, R square is equal to, or R is equal to, we got geometric mean b y x or b x y. Here we have written plus minus sign. This sign is depend on the sign of these two regression coefficient. If both are negative, we will write R value in negative form. Or if both are positive, we write R value in positive form. So that's why I have taken here plus minus both. It's depend. So the sign of R is depend on the sign of regression coefficient. If both are positive, R will be positive. And if both are negative, R will be negative. Okay. Now let's come to the second property. Second property is, if one of the regression coefficient is greater than 1, then then other must be less than 1. Okay, so second property, if one of the regression coefficient is greater than 1, then other must be less than 1. Okay, if one of the regression coefficient is greater than, that means greater than 1, then other must be less than 1. Okay, suppose this regression coefficient is greater than 1, the value of this regression coefficient is greater than 1, then it must be other one will be less than 1. Okay, if this is greater than 1, then this will be less than 1. So now let's do the proof. So let's begin proof. Okay, so let's begin. Let b y x is greater than 1, let us suppose. So it implies that 1 by, if we take the reciprocal of this, it will be less than 1. You can write, so this is our 1. Okay, we get this as a 1. Okay, now also b y x into b x y is equal to r square, just we proved. So b y x into b x y must be less than equal to 1, because r lies between minus 1 to 1. Since r lies between minus 1 to 1, so this will be less than equal to 1, because r square is, from this we know that r square is less than equal to 1. Okay, so from this we can write b x y, suppose we are taking b x y is less than equal to 1 by, implies that 1 by b y x. Okay, so this is our number 2. Okay, so compare this 1 and 2. From 1 and 2 we get, okay, from 1 and 2, from 1 and 2 we get b of x y is less than equal to 1 by b of y x is less than 1. Hence we can say b of x y is less than 1. So directly this will be less than 1. So we have started with this b of y x is greater than 1, then we get this b of x y is less than 1. Okay, it is, must be b of x y is less than 1 from 1 and 2. Okay, so hope this is clear. We have done the proof that if one of the regression coefficient is greater than 1, then other must be less than 1. Okay, now let's come to the third property. Third property is regression coefficient are independent of change of origin but not scale. Okay, third one is regression coefficient are independent of change of origin but not scale. Okay, That means regression coefficient are independent of change of origin. That means how much origin we change, it doesn't matter, but how much scale we change, it does matter. Okay, so it is independent of change of origin, but it is dependent of change of scale. Okay, so let's start the proof. Let us suppose our original variable are x and y. After changing the origin and scale, we get new variable u and v. So u is equal to x minus a divided by h, and v is equal to y minus b divided by k. Let us suppose. So here h and k are greater than 0. We know that r of earlier we did r of xy is equal to r of uv, because we have done this in correlation coefficient properties, that correlation coefficient r is independent of change of origin and scale. So we know that r of xy is equal to r of uv. Again, standard deviation is independent of change of origin but not scale, that you have done in measure of dispersion chapter. So we know that sigma x is not directly equal to sigma u, but it is h sigma u. Okay, so we have taken this part from the previous knowledge. Okay, this we know that r is independent of change of origin and scale, so we have written r of xy is equal to r of uv. And from the standard deviation knowledge, we have studied standard deviation properties. So standard deviation is independent of change of origin but not scale. So that means sigma x is not directly equal to sigma u. You have to write how much you have changed. So it is related in this way. So sigma x is equal to h sigma u. And similarly, sigma y is equal to k sigma v. Now, we need to show regression coefficient are independent of change of origin and scale. That means, what is the relationship between bxy and buv? Okay, they are not directly equal because it is independent of change of origin but not scale. So, we have to put the scale. So, to show the relationship between these two, that means bxy and buv. So, let try to find now byx. So byx is equal to r of xy by definition r xy I have written because we have taken two variable uv and xy also there. So original variable which is xy here, so it is sigma y by sigma x. So we can write it r of uv, because in place of r of xy it is r of uv, so I have written directly r of uv. Okay, then k sigma v, because here it is sigma, in place of sigma y I have written this. Okay, I am using this from previous knowledge. In place of sigma x I will write this h sigma u. Okay, so it is equal to this is k by h, and we will get r of uv, k by h r of uv sigma v by sigma u. Okay, so it is what, k by h, this is what, it is the formula of regression coefficient. Okay, regression coefficient, we can write it in the terms of regression coefficient, that is b u in this way. Okay, same we can do for b of x y. As we know, b of x y is equal to r of x y, original variable, in place of sigma y. Here we x is first, so we write x here first, then sigma y. So it is equal to, in place of r of x y, directly you write r of u v. Okay, then in place of sigma x, again you write h sigma u, and in place of sigma y, you write k sigma v. And then again HK you take outside, HK you take outside, and write this, you will get B U V. Okay, so it means B of XY is equal to, not directly equal to B of BU, but it is K by H B U V. Same here, this is equal to this. Okay, that means h by k. So h is scale change, k is scale change. So how much scale you change, it does matter, but how much origin you shift, it doesn't matter, because here we didn't get a and b, only h and k. So this is equal to this when we multiply it by h by k. Okay, same here it is k by h, and here it is h by k. So hope we have completed this properties, first three properties of regression coefficient, which are, again I am repeating, the first one is the geometric mean of the regression coefficient is the correlation coefficient. And second one is, if one of the regression coefficient is greater than 1, then other must be less than 1. And the third one is, regression coefficient are independent of change of origin but not scale. And the fourth one is, that is the arithmetic property that you do yourself. The arithmetic mean of the regression coefficient is correlation coefficient, provided that rho is greater than 0. Okay, so last one is the arithmetic mean of the geometric regression coefficient you have to find. So you do yourself the fourth property. I've shown you the first three properties. Thank you.